So one of the biggest myths in the entire money world is people think that time is money. We hear that from when we're a little kid. Money is time, time is money. But time is actually not money at all. In fact, with money, you can always go out and make more money. You can get a part-time job, you can start a side hustle, but your time, you never get back your time. You know, this moment is really all there is. And so that's one of the things. If you always think that you need to trade your time for money, you're going to be making trade-offs like spending more time with your family that you really shouldn't be making. So that's one of the keys in the book, trying to think about money as something very different. You can always go out and make more money.
It's a lot. It sounds like this is a lot about your emotional well-being as well as your financial well-being.
True.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. The better you kind of know yourself and what makes you happy, and that's one of the things too. A lot of the things that tend to make us happy are pretty inexpensive or actually free. And so how do you build your life to maximize the time to do those things, as opposed to just trying to make more and more money.
Exactly.
So one of the things that I wanted to show you is that a lot of people actually make, unfortunately, less money than they think. So when you start thinking about money in units of time, you want to calculate how much money you're actually making. And so the average person in the United States, you know, they work from 9 to 5, but in reality, you have to get up, say, at 7 a.m. for your job. And you'd probably sleep in if you didn't have to work for money. And so the average American actually, instead of working a 9 to 5, they work a 7 to 7 schedule because they're commuting. Say you're making or your family's making $60,000 per year. And instead of calculating your wage based on that, you look at how much time you're actually spending. So 12 hours a day.
You're spending 12 hours, not for every 8.
Exactly, because you have to commute, and then you come home and you're tired, and so you lounge out. You spend your time very differently than if you don't have to work for money. And so when you actually do that calculation, you're making about $13 per hour. And that's when it really starts to add up, because when you start looking at something like, let's say, a vacation. We all love vacations, right? It's really cold here in New York. We want to travel. So a $2,000 vacation, you think, oh, $2,000. A lot of money, but I have that. But when you take that, say, $13 that you're actually making per hour and you factor it in, this vacation is actually costing you a month of your life.
So wow.
A month of your life. It's just like, is it worth it?
Being more mentally aware of what you're spending your money and how much money you're actually earning.
And that you're actually trading your time for it. And then that's when it gets really crazy, because if you think, okay, yes, it's worth it to me to take this $2,000 vacation, I'm going to take it. But if you invested that $2,000 instead, that's when things start to get a little crazy, because when you actually look at this calculator, I call it the price of freedom calculator, and you do a calculation, you know, remember...
Oh, we can follow right here.
Yeah, we're looking at money in units of time, not just units of money. So let's say you have $25,000 saved in your retirement account, and your retirements are going to grow about 7% per year, and inflation's about 2.5%. Let's see how much that $2,000 vacation actually cost us. Look at this. $2,000 would buy you 654 days of freedom.
654 days.
No way.
So look at this.
2 years.
Look at this. This vacation cost you 1 month of your life to work to get the money.
But if you had invested it...
But if you had invested it, you're actually going to have to work.
It had given you...
Yeah, 2 years.
2 years.
You have 2 years of freedom.
Wow.
What it would give you.